Welcome to the Defense and Aerospace Report. I'm Vagam Radian here at the Paris Air Show at this historic airfield, Le Bourget, outside the French capital, where our coverage is sponsored by Bell and Leonardo DRS. And one of the most fun parts of the job is getting a chance to take a look at new aircraft, including the one you see right behind me. And it's my pleasure to be talking to Lieutenant Colonel Wes Spurlock, who is the commanding officer of the 344th Air Refueling Squadron out of sunny McConnell Air Force Base in the nation's heartland, flying the brand new, actually the very first, tail number 009, the very first KC-46A Pegasus tanker by Boeing in the United States Air Force. Colonel, congratulations on the bouncing new airplane.
Thank you, Vago, and thanks for coming out to see us today. We're sure excited to have you and sure excited to be here at Paris. It's a great time.
It's utterly fantastic. Obviously, a lot of delays getting the program in. We talked to Dr. Roper, regarding deficiencies and things like that on the airplane side that he's not happy about, but Boeing is working on the problems. Talk to us from your standpoint about the guys who are operating this jet, the first unit, putting the airplane through IOTNE. Talk to us about what the jet's like to live with.
So it's been a dream for us in the last couple months to finally get our hands on the airplane. There's been guys waiting here for years, getting trained and staying qualified in the airplane that they were flying. And now that they get their hands on, they get to see and they get to go fly and take it around the flagpole and take it around the world. It's their dreams are starting to come to fruition. It's been a great experience for everybody. We're learning every day. We're getting better every day. But right now, it's just a great time to be part of this team and part of this program.
You're obviously a tanker airlift pilot with some experience. Talk to us about how the airplane is different from the KC-135, legendary airplane, 800 of them originally the Air Force bought, more than 400 are in service, the backbone of the air refueling fleet. Eventually it'll be supplanted by the KC-46, but at 14 a year that transition is going to take a little bit of time. Talk to us about how the two airplanes differ in mission, in capability. Fuel offloads about the not all that different, but this airplane brings a lot to the table. Walk us through.
And yeah, the KC-135, and that's very near and dear to our heart, especially at McConnell Air Force Base, where we're flying that mission every day. Our guys are going down range, and they're bringing gas to the AOR. But for the KC-46 coming online, we know there's going to be some time as we work out the kinks. The difference is, like you said, the offload is not that big of a difference, but we're talking a 1950s era airplane to a 2015 era airplane. This is a modern aircraft that you'd see in any other 767. It also provides us communication capabilities that we've not seen to take this plane anytime, anywhere. One of the biggest things that we're starting to see in this airplane is the capability for aeromedical evacuation on every airplane out there. All 179 airplanes will have the ability to in-system select and put an aeromedical evacuation team on board and save lives wherever that may be, anywhere in the world. At the same time, we can be giving off gas and we can be moving cargo all in one airplane, all at the same time. On top of that, the ability to communicate both to the ground and anywhere else to our partners that are flying with us. So this is a different way of looking at things. It's not just a tanker, it's a multi-role airplane that's allowing us to do all of those all at the same time. For a KC-135, we had to decide whether we were going to air refuel Air Force aircraft or we're going to air refuel Navy and our coalition partners. This, much like the KC-10, gives us the opportunity to switch in between any time throughout the flight.
And you guys also have some smart tanker capabilities as well to act as a connectivity hub to basically be able to create a communications grid over a forward battle space.
Yes, and so the KC-135 prides itself on being the tanker, and they have been the tanker, and they have brought that fight from the Cold War into the Afghanistan War, and they're continuing to do that every day. But the KC-46, we see that as an air refueling aircraft with communication capabilities that we've not seen yet in that mission system or in that weapon system area, and it's allowing us to branch out and see what other holes we can fit into as we think about across the stream in a strategic way, what other ways we can employ this airplane, and it's not just the tanker part of it. So as we come on, we're starting to think of ourselves as less of just a tanker, though we have that capability and we're doing it every day. From the very first sortie we flew out of McConnell, we've been offloading gas into airplanes and doing that tanker mission, but now we're starting to find. We're here today, we're working on moving cargo around the world in the en route structure. We're working with our partners here over in Europe, and we're gonna head out to the Pacific in the very near future. We're just working to branch out, spread that envelope. Now that we're the operators, the part of operational test and evaluation, now that the operators have their hand on the airplane, we're finding new things out every day, and we're learning this together with Boeing and our Air Force partners.
And talk to us about the cargo capability you guys have. Airplane's a little higher off the ground, but you also have a bigger cargo capability.
So the if you get into this, if you inside the KC-46, we have the ability to take up to 18 pallets. We have to put those side by side. So, but that's a much bigger, much more pallets. We can put more pallets on this than the KC-135. It allows us to put them side by side. But also, there's the we're going to have to contour them to make sure they fit inside the airplane. But that's a different mindset than the 135 is used to. Cargo is really more of an afterthought. And as we hit the ground running, as we start to fully employ this new airplane, we want to make sure that we spread across and learn all the mission sets that we have from the very beginning, so we can make sure that we provide the warfighters with the very best that we can provide with this airplane.
Talk to us a little bit, two questions. Talk to us a little bit about the training pipeline and how you guys are bringing folks up to speed, because the idea is to try to generate as many crews as possible to man all of the airplanes. For those folks in our audience, because of the delays in delivery and acceptance, airplanes kind of have been backing up and air crews have not been able to qualify. So I mean, part of getting these airplanes back and, you know, getting into the airplanes in service has been to be able to also pump those crews out. Talk to us a little bit about the schedule you guys are on to train up, get people ready, the simulator, the whole enchilada that helps bring a new type into service.
Got it. So at McConnell, in just the last couple months, we've gotten a simulator there. So we, as the operational base, are working on it. It's helping us doing our standard training. Altus Air Force Base is tasked with the standing up and training, as all Air Force mission sets are, of training all of our initial training for our initial qualification. The men and women of the 344th and McConnell Air Force Base and our 924th partners in the reserves have been there at what we call initial cadre for the KC-46. So their training was conducted via Boeing, and we went up there and they trained us. We all got type ratings in the 767, and then it's been more of a focus on the simulator type training, as most modern aircraft are in the airlines and abroad. But right now, the initial cadre are standing up and flying the airplane now that we've got our hands on it. We have some IPs, we're bringing on some aircraft commanders, but it is a the high time in this aircraft is not, I don't think anyone right now has more than 100 hours right now in the KC-46 for our IOT&E unit, but we're working together every day with Boeing and with our flight safety partners to stand up and work through the training on that. It's new for everybody, so it's a new day. We're learning something new every day and we're working on it, but right now it's a really exciting time, because to build and work through those problem sets together is providing us with a more capable airplane than we even expected to have.
And well, last question, in terms of availability, obviously it's based on a tried and true, very successful commercial jetliner design. Again, there were some of those questions about challenges and the like. But from an availability standpoint, is the airplane living up to your expectations as a commanding officer to be ready to be able to move the gas and the cargo when you need it?
So for the most part right now, we're in a training set. So we're not having any missions going to require us drop everything and go there. So we're training, so we're trying to hold back and make sure that we make sure it's the right time to push. But all I can tell you is every time I've stepped to a jet, I've taken off. And our maintenance team is phenomenal, but they too are working through a new way of doing things. This is not the KC-135 way that we did this through the 1950s going on. This is the way that the modern airlines are maintained. And we have the best maintainers, and they've been working on this for years, working with Boeing to figure out a new problem set and a new way to go down the decision trees that Boeing has provided them. Because we're not just, the Air Force is not just providing the regulations by with our guys are going to maintain it. They're working through Boeing, and that's a new thing. And so we're trying to make sure we work on the crawl, walk, run approach to that. And that comes with learning. That comes with hoping that we go through together in the future. And this is the beginning of the next generation of AR. So we need to make sure that we understand that. And also that working with Boeing to make this airplane better, because there's still things we got to work out. And we're going to work those out like we've continued to do. You know, going and doing our training with them, we know the people, we've worked with them, and they really genuinely are trying to make us better. And we really appreciate that. And we just look forward to getting with them and fixing these things as we go through this together.
And visiting the Paris Air Show is not too shabby.
Not a bad day for any of us. So the weather, the sun, the overcast a little bit, so it's because some of our guys have looked a little red in the face. The sunscreen is not as flowing as it should be over here.
Well, that's right, because so many people are coming by and seeing you. And last question, your last job, this is the coolest job because everybody in the United States Air Force and the military looks to command their own unit, but you also had a pretty cool job the last time around where you carried the football for both President Obama and for President Trump. What kind of an experience was that like to be at that level of power and doing actually one of the most iconic jobs in the military, which is to provide the commander-in-chief with the codes should that ever be necessary?
To be honest with you, that was a great experience, and I got to work with some great people, and it's humbling and all that. But right now, with the men and women of the 344, this is the place I want to be, and this is the best job in the Air Force, and I wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
Lieutenant Colonel Wes Spurlock, who is the commander of the 344th Air Refueling Squadron in McConnell, sir, thanks very much. Amazing airplane. We look forward. You know, I believe I saw this very airplane when it was on the production line.
Yeah.
So it's really, really great to actually see it out here. It's best of luck to you guys, and look forward to visiting with you guys at McConnell to see the airplane up close and personal.
We'd love to have you. Thanks so much, Fog. It was nice to meet you.